I received this example from an old and very proven religious who said that when he was a prelate, whenever he was about to begin some task pertaining to his office of governing the monastery, if he did it according to his inclination, God most often allowed some anxiety and tribulation. And if on the contrary he did it according to the counsel and inclination of the majority of his subjects, it always turned out well, and often he found himself consoled. Now then, how could the subject, especially one religion, have such presumption that she would want to live by her own lies and her foolishness, her foolish fervor, and not rather by the counsel and will of her superior and mistress? So that the virtue of holy humility might shine in her, and the woman of self-defense might be wielded by her to the praise of Christ. Servant and spouse of Christ, by the permission of God, finds herself in a grave and dangerous storm. She cries from her heart toward heaven, saying, God, do not abandon me. Then her